Have you ever found anything by accident? Maybe you were searching for something in your closet, only to stumble across something else you've been trying to find for months. Well, you're not the only one. Except some people end up discovering and inventing some genuinely crazy things. From an underground city to Vaseline, here are 20 accidental discoveries you've probably never heard of. Number 20. A 700-year-old mummy. When Chinese workers went to work in Tanzhou City in the Jiangsu province of China, they probably expected it to be like any other day, long and probably quite dull. They were widening the road, which meant they were working below the road surface. And it was once they reached the bottom of the road surface, about 6 feet down, that they discovered something unusual, a mysterious box. But it was no ordinary box, that's for sure. Upon opening it, the road workers discovered a body. It was a 700-year-old female mummy within a wooden box coffin. Due to the brown preserving liquid within the box, she was beautifully preserved, almost as if she had been inside there for months rather than hundreds of years. Experts believe she dated back to the Ming Dynasty, which was China's ruling power from 1368 to 1644. The lack of deterioration was incredible. She still had her skin, her hair, her face, even her eyelashes. Looking at her hand, her skin was wonderfully preserved, and she was wearing a ring. What was also quite remarkable about the find was how she was laid out. She was dressed up in a traditional Ming Dynasty costume featuring silk, and her coffin was filled with ceramics, bones, relics, and ancient writings. Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Number 19. An 18th century toy. Perhaps the last thing you would expect to find in the latrine of an old school of swordsmanship is an old adult toy dating back to the second half of the 1700s. Archaeologists had been excavating an ancient latrine in Poland's Baltic city of Gdańsk when they found the phallus-shaped 250-year-old artifact. Due to its shape, it became immediately apparent to the archaeologists that it was a tool of pleasure rather than for religious purposes or anything else. It was 8 inches long, made of leather, and had a bristle stuffing material with a wooden tip. Probably not unsurprisingly, it was pretty out of place at the archaeological site. Previously, all they had been finding at the old school were wooden swords for training, pottery, and jewelry. After some research, probably in incognito mode, archaeologists believe it was an expensive toy, especially given the high-quality leather. Although, it wasn't known whether it was dropped in this specific location on purpose or by accident. Regardless, it would have made those researching the history of erotica quite excited. Although, the fact that it exists isn't really all that surprising. References to sexual aids date back hundreds of years. Women and men used phallic objects for pleasure. Number 18. A living fossil. Imagine being a researcher and thinking that a particular fossil and the existence of its life were completely eradicated, only for it to show up alive and well 273 million years later. That is exactly what happened to scientists in Japan. Non-skeletal corals that grew from marine animals called sea lilies, or crinoids, were found on the Pacific Ocean floor near Honshu and Shikoku in Japan. According to researchers in a paper, the species represented the first detailed records of a crinoid, the host, and a hexacoral. During the Paleozoic era, corals and crinoids got along well, and there were plenty of examples of corals overgrowing the crinoid stems to climb up above the seafloor for filter feeding in strong ocean currents. But then, they disappeared from records about 273 million years ago when those specific corals and crinoids in question went extinct. Other corals and crinoids re-emerged in subsequent eras, but never in a symbiotic relationship, as previously discovered. However, all those many millions of years later, at 330 feet below the ocean surface, rare hexacorals and a sea anemone called Metridoidea that grows from the stems of living Japanese lilies were found. You can just imagine how amazed that research team was. Number 17. An underground city in Turkey. Okay, so get ready to have your mind blown. Imagine this for a scenario. You're renovating your home and you knock down a wall. Instead of seeing building materials and not much else, you see a passageway leading to a network of chambers and tunnels. In the Cappadocia region of Turkey, this actually happened. In 1963, a man was renovating when he knocked down a wall and found this massive underground city. It led to stone tunnels and chambers, which experts believe were once meeting halls, stables, freshwater wells, and shops. There were even heavy stone doors, which were thought to be forms of protection for the residents living and residing within. Underground cities aren't exactly rare in Turkey. Dozens of them have been found in the Cappadocia region of Turkey, many of which were hand-carved by volcanic ash hundreds of years ago. However, this one, called Derinkuyu, is definitely one of the most elaborate and also one of the most recently discovered. After a complete investigation, it was revealed that it contained at least 18 stories and had enough room to house up to 20,000 people. It literally is a city underground, and this man was living next to it for years without even knowing. Number 16. Bacteria and Protozoa. Perhaps one of the most incredible and life-changing discoveries ever made was by Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. He was the first man to observe bacteria and protozoa. You could pretty much say he changed life as we know it. Antoni, from the Netherlands, was a Dutch microscopist born in 1632 who is considered the father of microbiology. He designed and made a single-lens microscope to observe and experiment with microbes. He called them dierkens, which means small animals in Dutch. Antoni was also the first to start documenting his microscopic observations, particularly on bacteria, red blood cells, spermatozoa, and muscle fibers. He was among the first people to see blood flow in capillaries. Surprisingly, Antoni didn't write any books on his findings, but he did note down his discoveries in letters to the Royal Society and people in European countries. The Royal Society published many of his letters. By the end of his very interesting life and career, he had discovered infusoria, which are small aquatic creatures from freshwater ponds, bacteria like selenomonads from the human mouth, vacuoles, the banded pattern of muscular fibers, and spermatozoa, which are moving sperm cells. Number 15. Teflon. Roy Plunkett was a scientist working for DuPont. In 1938, he was trying to come up with a way to make refrigerators safer for homes, which meant replacing the refrigerants in them that consisted of propane, sulfur dioxide, and ammonia. So, not exactly very home-friendly. He had been working on a particular sample, but when he went to open the container he'd been storing it in, he discovered the experimental gas had disappeared. In its place was a weird, slippery, resin-white powder that ended up being resistant to chemicals and heat. Finally, Roy realized that his container of tetrafluoroethylene, a gaseous species, had polymerized into polytetrafluoroethylene. It was a waxy, solid fluoropolymer that seemed to be corrosion-resistant and resistant to high heat. After that, his accidental invention was used in the automotive industry, the Manhattan Project, and cookware. You may know it today as Teflon. That's right, Roy Plunkett is the reason we don't have to scrub our pans for hours trying to move the residue of stuck food. Thanks, Roy. You're a champion. Number 14. Velcro. Cockleburrs are one of the most annoying things to come across when you're out in the wilderness. They stick to your clothing, your hair, and the fur of your pets. They can take ages to get out, and they're sharp and prickly when left in place. For many of us, they're a nuisance, but for engineer George de Mestral, they were an opportunity to create something unique. George had been hunting in Switzerland's Jura Mountains with his dog in the 1950s when cockleburrs became stuck on his pants and in his dog's fur. He was curious about how they were attached in place and noticed that they had small hooks adhering to the fabric of his pants. That must have really stuck with him, pardon the pun, because George is now responsible for having invented Velcro. He established Velcro SA in Switzerland in 1952, which consisted of hook and loop fasteners that he replicated from cockle burrs. He filed a patent in 1955 and opened Velcro USA in Manchester, New Hampshire in 1957. Now, you see Velcro on almost everything that may have previously needed a button or string. Thanks to George, we've been able to avoid the frustration of adhesion for many years. And I, for one, couldn't be more grateful. Although, he could have come up with a solution for cockle burrs and we would have been much happier. Number 13. The Implantable Pacemaker. Many people wouldn't be alive today without pacemakers. They are electronic devices implanted in our bodies to regulate our heartbeats if they aren't doing it on their own. Each year, tens of thousands of people undergo surgery to receive this life-saving product. So, who do we have to thank for it? Canadian electrical engineer John Hobbs. In 1941, he was researching how radio frequency heating impacts hypothermia when he discovered something incredible. When a temperature drop caused the heart to stop beating, he could restart it artificially with an electrical or mechanical stimulation to make it beat. It was actually John's research that paved the way for the first cardiac defibrillation machine. John used it to restart a dog's heart in 1949. It ended up actually being through research on dogs that he invented the first pacemaker device. It was too big to be used internally, but everything takes time to be developed. American electrical engineer Wilson Greatbach created the first implantable cardiac pacemaker along with pacemaker batteries to make it function. John ended up benefiting from something he had started all those years ago. In 1984, he had an internal pacemaker fitted to regulate his own heart, which was replaced with a new one 13 years later. Number 12. The Rosetta Stone. The Rosetta Stone was a granodiorite steel created in 196 BC and found in 1799. And to say it was an incredible find was an understatement. Etched on it are three versions of a decree from the Ptolemaic dynasty, which are on behalf of King Ptolemy V of Epiphanes. The text on the bottom is ancient Greek, while the middle and top sections appear to be in Demotic and hieroglyphic scripts from ancient Egypt. The stone also appears to be a fragment of a much larger one, because none of the text is actually complete, but later searches didn't turn up anything. Researchers believe it was carved during the Hellenistic period and put on display in a temple near Say. Eventually, the massive stone was used to construct Fort Julian in the Nile Delta. French officer Pierre-François Bouchard discovered it in 1799 during the Napoleonic campaign in Egypt. It caused quite the stir as it was the first ancient Egyptian bilingual text to be found in modern times. Soon, though, the British had defeated the French and they took the stone to London in 1801. It has been on display in a British museum and is among the most visited items ever since. Number 11. The Hoxton Hoard. Tenant farmer Peter Watling from the village of Hoxton in Suffolk was only looking for his hammer when he and his friend Eric Laws stumbled across the largest hoard of silver and gold from late Roman times in Britain. Peter had called upon Eric, an amateur metal detectorist and retired gardener, to help look for his hammer in a field. He could have just purchased a new one, but his hammer was definitely out there somewhere, so why not find it? While they were searching, Eric found silver spoons, gold and silver coins, and gold jewelry. After this discovery, they notified the landowners, which was the Suffolk County Council, and didn't dig any further. Archaeologists from the Suffolk Archaeological Unit turned up to carry out an emergency excavation. During it, they removed the decayed remains of a wooden chest, which was stacked full of valuable treasure. We're not kidding either. There were 7.7 pounds of gold, 52.4 pounds of silver, coins, jewelry, spoons, ladles, toiletries, items, silver vases, and many other valuable items. All in all, it was valued at the time at 1.75 million pounds, which was given to Eric as the finder. He shared it with Peter, and Peter donated his hammer to the British Museum since it started this whole thing. Number 10. Life beneath the ice shelves of Antarctica. researchers had always believed that life couldn't survive in the extremely cold and harsh conditions of Antarctica. So you can imagine their surprise when they accidentally discovered 16 sponges and 22 unidentified species on a rock in extreme conditions under the ice shelves of Antarctica. Up until their discovery, which was published in a study in 2021, researchers thought that sea life decreased as the depth increased on the Antarctic ice floor. Now, they have to re-examine that theory. After using borehole cameras, researchers at the British Antarctic Survey spotted the sponges and unidentified species attached to a rock out of sunlight. Filter feeders could adapt and survive in temperatures of up to -2 degrees Celsius, but these were found in temperatures far below that. They identified 1 stalked sponge, 15 non-stalked ones, and nearly 2 dozen stalked organisms they couldn't even identify from captured imagery. At that point, they had no idea how the organisms were able to access food, but you can imagine they're going to be spending a lot of time finding out now. They'll need a way to access practical samples and study them to see how they live in such harsh conditions and manage to eat. Number 9. The Big Bang. Our whole universe was in a hot, dense state. Then nearly 14 billion years ago, expansion started. Wait, okay, enough of the Big Bang theory. Let's talk about the Big Bang itself. Did you know it was discovered by accident? Boy, what an incredible thing to learn without really meaning to. And to think, it all started with radio static. In 1964, 2 astronomers were working with the Homedel antenna in New Jersey when they noticed a strange background noise. It confused them, and they had no idea where it had come from or what it was. They ruled out nuclear tests and interference from urban areas. They even made sure that pigeons weren't living in the antenna to cause the strange static. It was then that the 2 astronomers, Robert Wilson and Arno Penzias, unearthed a theory that would land them a Nobel Prize. They came across Robert Dicke's theory that background cosmic radiation could be radiation left over from a Big Bang that formed the universe. Funnily enough, just 37 miles from the Princeton University-based Homedel antenna, Robert Dicke and his team had been trying to find that background radiation. When he found out what the 2 astronomers had discovered, he said to his research partners, "Well, boys, we've been scooped." Number 8. Intraocular lens. Have you ever tried to do something you believe will be great, only to face strong opposition from those around you? Sure, people not agreeing with what you're doing can make it harder to achieve your goals, but Harold Ridley is proof you can still do great things with or without the support of your community. Harold saw many Royal Air Force casualties during World War II, including those with eye injuries. What he observed pretty early on was that people's eyes didn't tend to have an inflammatory reaction to pieces of aircraft cockpit canopy acrylic, but they did with glass splinters. With time and research, Harold started to ponder whether he could create artificial lenses out of the same material to treat cataracts. So he manufactured a lens using branded Perspex and achieved the first intraocular lens implant in 1949. The following year, he created a permanent artificial lens. Rayner Company manufactured the first lens, and they continue to market these small incision intraocular lenses today. Throughout the entire process, he had strong opposition in the medical community, but he continued to refine his technique. Today, intraocular lens implantation in cataract extraction surgery is the most common eye surgery. Number 7. Vaseline. Today, we know Vaseline is an American brand that produces petroleum jelly-based products. The plain petroleum jelly is even present in a variety of soaps, skin creams, deodorants, cleansers, and lotions. Vaseline was actually created by pure chance. Robert Chesebro was a chemist who was in the business of clarifying kerosene from sperm whale oils. In 1859, he visited the oil fields of Titusville, Pennsylvania to look at what new materials he could create from the fuel. This was when he learned about rod wax, a residue that had to be removed from oil rig pumps. oil workers had actually been using the wax to heal their cuts and burns, so Robert took samples of it back to Brooklyn with him. He extracted usable petroleum jelly from it and turned it into a medical product he named Vaseline. Today, we use it as a lubricant and as a moisture insulator for skin conditions. However, we learn a lot with research, and some research about cosmetics containing mineral oils came out in 2015. German consumer watchdog Stiff Tongue Warentest found high levels of mineral oil aromatic hydrocarbons and polyaromatics in some products containing mineral oils. These are seen by the European Food Safety Authority as possibly carcinogenic. Vaseline had some of the highest levels, and Stiff Tongue Warentest warned people not to use Vaseline or other products that contained mineral oils. Number 6. Saddle Ridge Hoard. A couple only known as John and Mary lived at an undisclosed location in California gold country. While walking their dog on their property one morning in 2013, they discovered a massive amount of treasure that has come to be known as the Saddle Ridge Hoard. They had hiked the same trail on their property many, many times before, but it wasn't until they noticed a rust-covered metal can poking out of the ground that they decided to look closer. Then it all fell into place. They had previously seen an odd-shaped rock on a hill and a can hanging from a tree that had been there so long the tree had grown around it. They believe these were markers for the original owner of 1,427 gold coins they unearthed, with a face value of $27,980.
I could tell that this was something that we'd never seen before. I mean, we've seen the shipwrecks.
Now worth around $10 million. The hoard they uncovered consisted of over $27,000 in $20 coins, $500 in $10 coins, and $20 in $5 coins. They all dated back to between 1847 and 1894. Their amazing find remains one of the most significant known discoveries of buried gold coins in the United States. For obvious reasons, John and Mary's real names and location remain anonymous to stop people from visiting their property to look for treasure themselves. Number 5. The Dead Sea Scrolls. The Dead Sea Scrolls are ancient Jewish and Hebrew manuscripts discovered near Ein Feshke on the northern shore of the Dead Sea in the Qumran Caves of the Judean Desert. The scrolls had massive historical, linguistic, and religious significance and are thought to contain the second oldest surviving manuscripts of works that were later included in the Hebrew Bible canon. The Dead Sea Scrolls were found in a dozen caves around the site known as the Ein Feshke Caves between 1946 and 1956 by a team of archaeologists and Bedouin shepherds. They were discovered in earthenware vessels, and it was common practice to store them in the earth or caves. So far, many thousands of written fragments have been found in the area around the Dead Sea. The remnants form part of larger manuscripts that, through interference by humans and natural causes, have been reduced to mere scraps of text. That's not to say all of them are destroyed, though. Those discovered in the Qumran Caves were so well preserved that they were almost entirely intact. To date, researchers have a collection of about 981 manuscripts from 11 different caves discovered in that 10-year period. Number 4. Alexander Calder Flea Market. A lot of exciting things have been found at flea markets, which is perhaps why many people flock to them whenever they're held. But while you might pick up a few trinkets, they are likely to be nowhere near as valuable as the brass necklace a woman found at a Brooklyn flea market. The self-described flea market junkie had pulled it from a cardboard box that had already been thoroughly picked over. It was filled with vintage clothing and electrical goods. It wasn't until later that she saw a similar necklace on a Philadelphia Weekly cover promoting the Philadelphia Art Museum. After being encouraged to contact a specialist, she was stunned to find out her flea market find that cost her $15 almost a decade previously may end up fetching up to $300,000 at auction. It was described as being a genuine piece by the iconic 20th century sculptor by the name of Alexander Calder. His career spanned most of the 20th century, and he was known as an innovative genius who changed the course of modern art. So, the next time someone scoffs at you for rummaging through boxes at flea markets and garage sales, remind them of what's possible to find hidden amongst the junk. Number 3. The Venus de Milo. The Venus de Milo is an ancient Greek sculpture depicting a Greek goddess from the Hellenistic period. Out of all ancient Greek statues, Venus de Milo would have to be one of the most famous. After it was rediscovered on the island of Milos in 1820, it has been displayed at the Louvre Museum ever since. The half-clothed, bare-torsoed sculpture has no arms and is anything but intact, but it likely would have been a strikingly beautiful piece when it was first created. It would have had two arms, 2 feet, two earlobes, and a plinth. It's definitely a bit worse for wear now, but you can't blame her for looking a bit worn out, for she has had a rough time of it. She was found by a peasant called Yorgos Kontrotas in 1820, buried in the ancient city ruins of Milos. Yorgos and his son Antonio had stumbled across a small cave by accident when they found the statue covered with a heavy slab. She was in two pieces and was stored with other marble fragments. When the sculpture was found, it was a significant occasion, but it actually wasn't until much later that Venus de Milo became the icon it is today. Number 2. World's Largest Pearl. Have you got a good luck charm? Many people do. Sometimes it's a pair of lucky underwear, or it's your everyday classic rabbit foot keychain. For a fisherman in Palawan Island, Philippines, it's an almost 80-pound pearl with a price tag of about $100 million. He kept this lucky charm under his bed and carried on with his humble life as if he wasn't a multimillionaire. It was only recently displayed to the world, 10 years after its discovery. The fisherman was likely unaware of how much the pearl was worth. In 2006, the man had been fishing off the coast of Palawan Island when he noticed his boat's anchor was stuck on a giant clam. He swam down to unhook his anchor when he saw the shell containing a 2.2 foot long, 1 foot wide pearl. He took it with him, tucked it away under his bed, and likely never gave it much thought after that. But it wasn't until his house caught on fire that the pearl was discovered. He had to move it from his home and gave it to tourism officers in Puerto Princesa. They were amazed, and it's now believed to be the largest natural giant pearl from a giant clam in the world. The previous world record holder was just 14.1 pounds. And again, this one was almost 80 pounds. Number 1. Lascaux Cave. Kids love to explore, and sometimes that exploring can put them in some pretty desirable situations. In 1940, four French teenagers had been exploring the forests near Montignac with their dog when they found a hole in the ground. It was a pretty ordinary hole, but keen for an adventure, they decided to squeeze themselves into the stone shaft where they had actually discovered an underground cavern. But it was no ordinary cavern. The walls of it were covered in about 2,000 different engravings and ancient paintings. It was confirmed, and the world was in awe. Its vast collection of animal drawings and abstract symbols brought people from all over Europe and even the world. As it turns out, the paintings were up to 17,000 years old, and the cave was possibly a religious and hunting rites site for Upper Paleolithic people. Lascaux Cave in southwestern France remains a tourist attraction today. However, it's now closed to the public to protect it as a World Heritage Site. I can't imagine how exciting it would have been to make these discoveries. Imagine how your life could change. You might become well known for an invention throughout history, or rich from finding hidden treasure. What's the weirdest, strangest, most absurd thing you've ever discovered by accident? Did it earn you praise, a news story, or money? We're interested to hear your story. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.